Zone 6.
Good morning. I'm Paul Miller from Kansas City, Missouri. I've got two questions. First, not too long ago, I believe it was Fortune magazine that ran an article regarding personal tax rates. And at the risk of misquoting you, my recollection is that you favored higher personal rates, rates even higher than those proposed by those in Washington. The second question is, I've heard Berkshire Hathaway referred to as nothing more than a high-priced rich man's mutual fund. Would you care to comment on that also?
Well, on tax rates, if you ask me what I personally favor, I personally favor a steeply progressive consumption tax. That has a little more attention being paid to it now, although the steeply progressive might be modified by most of the advocates of the consumption tax, maybe to mildly progressive or something of the sort. There's a Nunn Domenici proposal along that line, and there are other people that are talking about it more. It may be examined by the new Kerry Danforth Commission, of which we've got a member in the audience. But I believe in, one way or another, I believe in progressive taxes. And so I am not shocked in terms of my own situation, and I don't think Charlie is particularly, about having a progressive income tax, although, like I say, I think society would run better over time if it were a progressive consumption tax instead. Do you want to comment on the tax situation, Jerome?
Well, I think there is a point at which income taxes become quite counterproductive if the progression is too high. But I don't think we're there yet.
We think, at least I think, I'm extraordinarily well treated by the society. I think most people with high incomes are. I think if you transported most of them to Bangladesh or Peru or something, they would find out how much of it is them and how much is the society. And I think there's nothing better than a market system in terms of motivating people and in terms of producing the goods and services that the society wants. But I do think it gets a little out of whack in terms of what the productivity maybe of an outstanding teacher compared to somebody who is good at figuring out the intrinsic value of businesses. I don't have a better system on the income side, but I think society should figure out some way to make those who are particularly blessed, in a sense, to have talents that get paid off enormously in a market system, to give back a fair amount of that to the society that produces that. The question about Berkshire being a, I think it was a rich man's mutual fund or something like that, we don't look at it that way at all. We look at it as a collection of businesses, and ideally we would own all of those businesses. So it's to the extent that a mutual fund owns stock in a lot of companies and diversifies among businesses, and we try to own a lot of businesses ourselves, I guess that's true, but I guess you could say the same thing of General Electric or an operation like that. We are more prone to buy pieces of businesses than the typical manager, but we are trying to do, in a sense, the same thing Jack Welch is trying to do at General Electric, which is try to own a number of first-class businesses. He gets to put the imprint of his own management, which I think is very good, on those businesses, and we are more hands-off both in the businesses we own outright and in the ones we own pieces of. But we're going at it the same way, and General Electric has been very successful under Jack's leadership in doing it his way. We think in terms of what we bring to the game and the problems of putting money to work all the time that our own system is, you know, will work best for us. Charlie?
Yeah, I've got nothing to add to that.